In this movie, we will explain how we list the total quantities of existing, demolished, or new building elements. We will list the net surfaces of walls according to renovation status, type, and thickness. If we wish, we can list the other building elements too, like doors and windows, zones, etc., similarly to the wall. We will use the interactive schedule to set up the component list. Let's open the document, Schedules and Lists, Schedules, Scheme Settings dialog. Let's select the wall list and click the Duplicate button. Let's enter Renovation Wall List for name and click OK. Let's delete all parameters in the Filed tab page, except thickness and net surface. Let's extend the general parameter group on the left and add the layer and renovation status to the right side. Let's drag the renovation status to the top of the list and the layer to the second place. Let's switch to the Criteria tab page. We don't want to list the thin walls below 50 millimeters, so let's click the Add button and exclude the width below 50. Let's click OK to leave the dialog. Let's activate the newly created scheme in the Navigator. This opens the renovation wall list. Let's zoom into the list and click the Fit Width button. Let's check the Show Uniform Items as a Single Entry checkbox. Here we can see the net surfaces of the walls sorted by various renovation statuses, layers, and thicknesses. We can easily change the renovation status of the listed elements. In addition, we can quickly select them on the floor plan and in the 3D window as well. Let's return to the list. Changing the renovation filters. By changing the renovation filters, we can sort the list according to the selected settings of the filter. This means we can list the existing and demolished parts together, or the existing with the new walls. The new construction filter shows every wall type together. The interactive schedule list helps us to see, edit, or save into an Excel file the quantities of the renovation projects.